Yes, indeed, folks. Listen to Blue Please here on CynicalBrit.com with myself, Total Biscuit. Right, okay, so let's read a few more of these 5-man to 25-man ideas, and then we'll talk a little bit about the imbecile of the week. Yes, indeed. Someone who is incredibly dumb. Well, to be fair, it's not the person that really stopped. Actually, yes, it is. I'm sorry. Let's not try and be reasonable here. Let's not try and be kind and understanding. No, the guy who started this thread was an idiot. Right, anyway. Let's have a look. So, Jerick has an idea regarding the Dead Mines. I've always been a fan of the Dead Mines, so I'd choose Van Cleef. The boss room would be a circular wooden deck. Remember the wooden bridge at the end of the Dead Mines? It would be that. The warship would be behind him and would slowly circle the platform. Abilities include Fire the Cannon. The warship stops in place and fires a large cannonball from its main cannon that flies straight across the platform. Cannonball is fast moving, but slow to fire to give people time to move to the safe edge of the platform. This is going to kill people if they land on them, I assume. Assassinate. The current tank is gouged for 15 seconds. Van Cleef runs towards the top threat healer, and if he gets a hit off on the healer dies. This requires an off-chank to taunt him. Fast. Van Cleef would shout something like, "Time to spill some blood." Would he really say that? I don't know. Corner him. Two variants of which. One, three of Van Cleef's guards creep up while stealthed on a high threat healer and try to ambush him or her. They will be relatively slow to strike but must be off tanked or the healer will die. And two, the three guards rush the tank and strike him all at once, causing a large damage spike. We'll call Rock the Boat. The crew of Van Cleef's warship rock the ship, causing a wave of water. The water will alternate between each side of the platform, hitting each 2+ times. If you are hit by the raid, hit by the wave, indeed. You are pulled with it off the platform, and then you are off the platform. You have mere seconds to get on one of four sets of stairs before the sharks eat you. I like this because this has sharks in it. That's awesome. I'm cool with this. This is the first boss encounter that I've seen with loads of sharks. So that's good. I like that. The sharks kill in two collective attacks, dealing 60% of your total health with each attack. And blastable way. If you take too bloody long, Van Cleef's crew will have armed all the cannons, which will all then be fired, killing everybody. Yeah, I'm cool with that. Really. Some good stuff. I'm happy with that. That's good. I like it. Right, so I'll do one more, and then we'll talk a little bit about the imbecile of the week, and I can send you on an internet field trip to have a look at this guy's thread. It's pretty terrible, let's be honest. Right, so. Let's have a look. What's good? What's good? What's good? What's not too long? That would be nice. Oh, shit. Some of you guys have written essays. I mean, this is all great. Go and have a look at the actual page itself. It's cynicalbit.com/blue-please/blue-please-season-4-episode-7. Yeah, I know, it's a little bit terrible. Just click the Blue Please archive on the show's page. You'll find it. Here's one. It's from Alavan. So, I know he's already a raid boss, but I'd like to see the Lich King encounter from the Halls of Reflection adapted into a raid encounter. Maybe use some character from Cataclysm or a Wall of Fire. This way it's timed in a way that is tangible and not just an enrage timer. Plus, it is the only, correct me if I'm wrong, encounter that has a racing game style checkpoint. When you break down a wall, you give yourself more time. I think you're probably right there. What I would improve would be to make harder modes harder, obviously. You would have to stay coordinated even though this big guy or Wall of Fire is walking up to kill you. Make each of the poles do something different, like a mini boss. Yeah, that works. I like that. That's pretty good. Excellent. Okay. Right, so let's continue on with this. By the way, if you're not in the chat room, go click the chat button at the bottom of the screen on cynicalbrit.com. That's the place to be. We've sort of abandoned the IRC channel. Video chat's better. Hey, it's just more convenient. Right. Okay, so imbecile of the week, ladies and gentlemen. Or should I say, where's the button? Here it is.
Imbecile
of the week.
Ah, the classics return. God, I need to rework that. That was awful. God, I think that was from my show back in 2005. Horrendous. Right, okay. So, imbecile of the week, ladies and gents. I shall give you a link to this momentarily. And is the dumbest thing. Honestly, God. It's called Let's Do This Fast, Please. Link in the IRC channel. Those of you who are listening to the show on the archive, I'll put this in the show notes for you so you can have a look at it. IRC channel, Tiny Chat, all there. Yes, indeed. Okay. So, let's read this. And let's look at what's so dumb about it. Here we go. From PSOX. From Aggressive Perfector on Anchorage. And she says this. Playing on my alt, leveling through LFD, let's do this fast, please, go, go, go. This is like poetry. It really is. It's like some really terrible avant-garde poetry spouted from the mouth of some kind of second-year English literate... Try again. God, I'm not even going to try it. Stupid student. There you go. Right on. So, I shall present this in the form of a prose. Playing on my odds, leveling through LFD. Let's do this fast, please. Go, go, go. !!! Switching over to main for my daily emblem. Go, go, FFS. Don't got all day. Meeting a fellow hoardy on my alt doing quests. Siri, don't have time to loot the mobs, so you can skin have to level fast. Raid time on my main. Okay, guys, let's do this fast. Haven't got all night. Wanna do the weekly, too. PvP, BG. Let's rush, need honor, lol. Joining VOA Pug. Hurry up! !!! I don't mean to QQ or whine, I'm just curious. What are all these people stressing about? Wouldn't it be a lot more fun if everyone kicked back a notch and actually enjoyed the game? I mean, when I play a single-player game, I'm not rushing to complete it as fast as possible. When I read a book, I don't skip at the end and read that first. And when I watch a film, I don't fast-forward the whole thing. Maybe ship some Valum in the catterbox. Valum! God! You're awful! Everything about you is terrible! Valum! Yeah. Anyway. Wow, he actually edited this. Right, anyway. So, this is... this is so dumb. The worst thing is people actually agree with them. They do. They actually agree with them. I agree 100%. I keep getting these go-goers in Wrath of the Lich King Rallons. We're going to say they ruined the whole dong for everyone. What? Ruined the whole dong for everyone? What does that even mean? Yes, personally, I ruined the worthless pile of excrement. The steaming, worthless pile of excrement. Yes, we ruin it for everybody. What is this nonsense? God. For instance, there was a rogue in one of the groups who left because, and I quote, "This group is too slow for me, bye." It's so stupid. What do you get from leaving the dungeon? Oh, I don't know. Not have your time wasted by a bunch of idiots. Maybe do a couple of dailies while the deserter wears off. I don't know about you, ladies and gents, but I don't want to spend 50 minutes in freaking Utgard Keep because some guy wants to chill out, relax, kick back, take a toke, and so forth. Screw the chill out, relax nonsense. Pro tip, every one of us has done every one of these instances 100 times over. We don't want to chill out, kick back, relax all cool, shoot some b-ball outside of the school when a couple of scrubs that were up to no good started slowing down my group in my neighborhood. I tried to pull one fight and the scrubs got scared and they said, "Well, you're going too fast, please leave and go to Bel Air." I whistled for a decent group, but it never came near because everybody sucks. Oh, God. It's infuriating. It really is. I can understand a brand new 80 being surprised by this. Wanting to do all of this cool stuff. I get it, but most people aren't new 80s. Do you not understand? Ah, they're not new. They don't want to see this crap again. And they don't want to slow it down. You know what? The worst thing about this, I replied saying, "Why are you so damn disrespectful?" This is what I said, because, right, so here's the thing. So I said, "Why do you think it's okay to waste other people's time, particularly one more often than not it is limited? Time is a precious resource. To waste that of others is one of the most selfish things you could ever do." So, some idiot paladin called Scoots from Frostmane replied and said, "So if time is so precious, why not spend it doing something productive? Rather than sitting at a computer, hitting a set number of keys to make pixels, fire pixels, out of pixels, to herf the derf, and to gain the pixels and possibly more derf." I can think of a number of reasons for that, in fact. The first reason for that is because I work 40 hours a week and I want to chill out when I get home. And by chill out, I don't want my time wasted. I got like 4 or 5 hours in an evening, which consists of a whole bunch of other stuff that I've got to do. Honestly, do you think that I want to take up one-fifth of that time with you in an instance. No, I'm sorry, but your winning charisma and adorable personality are not enough to make me want to spend any longer than is absolutely necessary in this terrible dungeon with you again. It's awful. It's so incredibly dumb. And there's no irony whatsoever in saying, it's ironic that someone is playing games, not about wasting time. Have you never heard of the concept of leisure time, you imbecile? Do you think I want my leisure time wasted? No. I want to get as much out of it as humanly possible. And you'll learn that when you get a damn job. That goes to everyone on this damn forum. It's horrendous. Absolutely disgraceful. Really. God. Absolutely appalling. I'm sorry, but the looking for dungeon system is not fun. It's not. It's a quick and easy way of getting through the content in order to get badges, and once I'm done with my frost badges, I'm not in those things again. That is why we are there, to get badges. Do we want, say, 10 badges an hour, or would we like 3? Oh, I wonder. Yes, I'd love to stay in this instance with you because you're too damn slow and you're relaxing and taking in the scenery. Ugh. Appalling. Absolutely awful. It is the height of irresponsibility. It is the height of entitlement. It is the height of hypocritical selfishness to come on and say, oh, let's just be nice and kick back. This people like this, the bleeding hearts. And I say that with as much spite, bile, and hatred as I possibly can. These people are a disgrace to the player base. They are a cancer within it, eating away. And you know what the worst thing about them is? They hide under the guise of nice players, helpful players. We're just chilling out. We're just casual. Yeah, you know what? I play less than you do. I am a casual player. You think I want to spend 5 hours on one boss? Or do you think I like to kill people? Funny that, isn't it? You think I want to get rid of the bosses as quickly as possible? A casual player should be concerned more about his time than a hardcore player because he has less of it. How is that basic mathematics difficult to understand? Oh, of course, because casual players, entitled casual players, bleeding heart casual players, don't like maths because it's too hard. Yeah. Bloody disgraceful. Absolute joke. My name is Total Biscuit, and you're listening to Blue Please here on CynicalBrit.com. We're back after the break with the Illusion of Choice. Yes, indeed. In the meantime, however, can we find something to describe these people? I'm sure we can. Let's have a look. Go through my library and look for stupid. There we go. Super Joint Ritual. Stupid, stupid man. This song may contain some strong language. Enjoy.